بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم. My dear students, welcome to your class General English Language. Here is our fourth lecture. And for today, we're going to cover three main sections in lecture number four: grammar, vocabulary, reading. The elements of our lecture are going to be do, did, done, and doing, and how we use them. Then we have section number two in the grammar section, I guess. Prepositions with time. Prepositions of time. حنعرف استخدامات at, on, and in. And we have the third section will be vocabulary previewing. يكون في عندنا بعض الكلمات. You need to memorize all of these vocabulary. حاولوا تحفظوهم وتستخدموهم as we use them in these examples. And we have reading section. We have a pronoun, word and pronoun reference, and scanning and skimming. Okay? We will start first of all with verb to do, does, did, done, and doing. All of these are used as a helping verbs in order to form questions, negative, or use as main verbs. فكل هذه تستخدم من أجل أنك تشكل سؤال أو نفي أو تستخدم as a main verb كفعل رئيسي. الآن نستخدم verb to do مع I, we, they, and you أو any subject which is a plural أو any plural subjects. Do is a present form of verb to do. على شكل الفعل المضارع. مرة ثانية نستخدمها مع I, we, they, you, or any plural subject. لاحظوا هذه الجملة الأولى. هذا مثال. We do the homework every week. We do the homework every week. We do. لاحظوا do هو present form. Okay, present form. اللي هو في المضارع. أخذ we جمع. اثنين she does the homework every week. لاحظوا does في هذا الجملة جاءت مع she لأنه does is a present form comes with he, she, it or any singular subject. Okay. بينما did هو الشكل الماضي past. It comes with a plural or singular subjects. تيجي مع الأفعال المفردة والأفعال الجمع. أفعال المفردة مثل he, she, it, did أو I, we, they, you, did. Okay. أما done قبل done خلينا نقرأ هذه الجملة. The students did the homework last week. The students did the homework last week. لاحظوا did جاء قبلها plural subject. ممكن يكون plural أو singular. ممكن نعملها singular مثلا نحكي the student did the homework. Student one student did the homework last week. Last week دلالة أيضا على إنه الجملة في الماضي. Okay. أما done هي دائما تأتي مع has وhave وhad. تأتي بعد has وhave وhad. فبنحكي سلمى has done the homework. Okay. While doing اللي هو أضفنا عليها ال ing هي active progressive. تيجي مع is, am, are, was, where. Okay? So we can use doing or ing verb with is, am, are, was, and where. After is, am, are, was, and where. هذه الجملة they are doing the homework now. لاحظ doing ليش ing؟ لأنه قبلها verb to be are. خلينا نشوف هذه التمارين الآن exercises. Sultan Farag his best to get full mark in the last homework. دائما أول شيء نتطلع على دلالات على الفعل وعلى دلالات الفعل. ماذا أعني؟ For example, how can I choose? How can I come to know that one of these A, B, C, D is correct or incorrect? الجملة فيها last. حكينا last هي دلالة ماضي. فشو بناخذ done ولا did ولا does ولا do؟ ناخذ did. did لأنه دلالة ماضي. بينما do مضارع بجمع الأفعال والضمائر الجمع مع الفاعل والضمائر الجمع. does بجمع الضمائر المفردة. okay. فاتن has فراغ the homework perfectly. done, did, do, does. بعد verb to has حكينا بيجي done. okay. number three, you will فراغ me a favor if you tell me the answer. بعد verb to will الauxiliary model verb المodel will المodels بالإنجليزي مثل will, can, shall, should بيجي بعديها الفعل infinitive مجرد ما عليه أي إضافات. طيب لو طلعنا الآن للخيارات just look at the board and see أي كلمة ما في عليها إضافة. لاحظوا do هنا عليها إضافة ال ing, هنا ing and هنا ال id did في الماضي, لكن هو الإجابة do. بعد will بعد المودلز لازم يكون الفعل infinitive مجرد خالي من الإضافات base form. okay. he always فراغ the right thing. he always دائما هذا present. okay. present he بتاخذ do ولا doing ولا does ولا done. it takes does. he does. he always does the right thing. we can't say he do because do is only used with the plural subjects. okay. and doing is incorrect because it's only used after verb to be like is, are, am, and was, and were. okay. number five, the students are blank the exercises now. now here to استخدم for the present. if we look at the sentence, if you look before the blank you will find are. as you know that after verb to be we should add ing. so the answer, the correct answer is doing. the students are doing the exercises now. we can't say the students are do. we can't say the students are done. you can't say the students are dead. لازم تكون الإجابة the students are doing. لأن حكينا بعد الـ ing تستخدم بعد أفعال be اللي هي is, are, am, was, and were. finally, number six, blank the homework yesterday. look at this sentence. اطلع هذه الجملة. لاحظت الآن إنه هنا في عندنا yesterday and this is a past is used in the past اللي هي في الماضي. وين هو الماضي في هذه الجملة؟ have you do؟ هذه خطأ. اصلا هي should be have you done. have you done. can you doing هذا ايضا خطا. it should be can you do لانه can هي models والmodels بيجي بعديها base form. الاجابه الصحيحه هي did you do. did you do the homework yesterday. did هي من is used with the past form. okay. and yesterday is one of the signs for the past tense. okay. let's move on now to the other section and the second section of our class, prepositions with time. We're going to cover three prepositions, ثلاث حروف جر, at, on, in. At, شكل مختصر, in short, is used before o'clock and night. On is used before days. In is used before years and months. Okay, look at this chart now. انظر لهذا الجدول. In this chart, I'm mentioning in details the functions of in, on, and at. Look first at the first side, right here. In. In is used for larger periods of time. اللي هي الفترات الزمنية الكبيرة. مثل ايش؟ مثل الشهر, month. نحكي in June. أو with year. مثل ما تحكي I was born in, born in فراغ. In 1990, in 1984, we can use it with decade, اللي هو العقد من الزمان, العقد من الزمان. In the 1990s, التسعينيات, in the 1980s. Also, we can use it with the centuries. Centuries means القرن. For example, in the 19th century, in the 19th century, في القرن التاسع عشر. Also, we can use it with the era. The era means الحقبة الزمنية. Like this example. You also can use in the following expressions. ممكن نستخدمهم في هذه. In a second, في ثانية. In a minute, في دقيقة. In a while, خلال فترة معينة. In the morning, في الصباح. In the evening, في المساء. In time, في الوقت المناسب, مش على الوقت. Okay, and in the beginning of the time, in the beginning of time. Okay, الآن المطلوب منكم انكم تعرفوا استخدامات إن. إنها بتيجي مع شهر, سنة, decade اللي هو القرن, أيضا عفوا العقد, والcentury اللي هو القرن, والحقب الزمنية, وهذه العبارات. لأنه في الامتحان حيكون في هناك أسئلة عن prepositions of time, prepositions that we use it with time. Okay, so for here we've covered the first one, which is in. Okay, the second one, on. Use on. Okay, it's right here. On. Okay, use on for smaller periods of time. Smaller periods of time معناتها وقت قصير, الوقت القصير, أقصر من الشهر. مثل day. Day مثل on March 1st 2009. أو ممكن تستخدمها مع weekday, أيام الأسبوع. On Tuesday, on Wednesday, on Sunday. أيضا you can use it with expressions like on the dot. On the dot means exactly on time. Okay, so I'll change way. Okay, so we can use it with expressions like these. On the dot. مثلا you should arrive on the dot. You should arrive on the dot. شو يعني on the dot؟ معناتها on time. On time معناته انه على الوقت. Okay, على الوقت بالضبط, يعني على الوقت exactly. اذا ايضا راينا استخدامات on. اما استخدامات at, we use at for precise periods of time. شو يعني precise periods of time؟ في وقت محدد. في وقت محدد, precise. مثل إيش؟ مثل hour. نحكي at noon, at midnight, أو ممكن time of the day, at 2 o'clock, at 2 a.m, at 2 p.m. a.m. هي للفترات الصباحية و p.m. للفترات المسائية. ممكن تحكي at the end of the day, at the end of the day, at the end of the year, at the end of the week, at the end of the month, end ها نهاية. أو ممكن تحكي at the beginning of the day, at the beginning of the week, at the beginning of the month, at the beginning of the year. Okay, لاحظوا هذه أيضا العبارات اللي استخدمناها, استخدمنا at معها. فأرجو أنكم تعرفوا استخدامات at, on, in. من هناك أسئلة في الامتحانات الفاينل عن prepositions of time. خلينا نعمل هذا الاكسرسايز الصغير. He goes to work 7 o'clock. 7 o'clock is a precise period of time, so it should take at. Okay, لأن حكينا on تستخدم مع larger periods of time, sorry, shorter periods of time, مثل day, week of day, بينما in تستخدم مع larger periods of time, مثل year, month, decade, century, okay, era, and some expressions like in the morning. Okay, she was born فراغ October. October is a month, شهر عشرة. شو لازم تاخذ at, in, on, with. شو لازم تاخذ in October. In لأنه حكينا is used with a larger period of time. Okay, بينما on تستخدم مع shorter period of time. At precise period of time. Number three, the weather is hot. The weather is hot. Summer. Summer is a season. Is it short or large? I will leave number three for you. You do it by yourself. Okay? Number four, students do not go to university Friday. Friday is a shorter period of time. هي day, a weekday. حكينا إنه a weekday نستخدم مع which one? On Friday. On Friday. لأنه in تستخدم مع larger period of time, at تستخدم مع precise period of time, مثل hour. Okay. عظيم. إذن هذه هي استخدامات حروف الجر in, at, وon. بدي تفهم استخداماتهم وتعملوا التمارين وتنتبهوا للشارت الجدول اللي أعطيتكم إياه وتحفظوا مع إيش, مع إيش بتيجي كل واحدة منهم. Well, the third section in this class is going to be the vocabulary section. Last time and last class we've also had a list of vocabularies. كمان محاضرة الفائتة أخذنا مجموعة من الكلمات. أرجو من الجميع أنكم تحفظوا هذه الكلمات ومعانيها في الإنجليزي واستخداماتها, حيكون في إكسرسايز. أنا في امتحان نهائي برضو حيأتي نفس الطريقة, بنفس الطريقة, مش exactly لكن بنفس the same way. Okay, مثل الأسئلة الموجودة عندنا في the classes, recorded classes. أول كلمة, كلمة garage. Garage means garage, a place to park your car. Okay, customers means meal. Customers نحكي المستهلكين أو الزبائن, people who buy things. Buy معناها يشتري. Profit, الربح. Money you earn in business. Earn معناها يكسب. Money you earn in business اللي هو أي عمل, or interest, فوائد. To purchase معناها to buy, like I purchased a laptop last month. اشتريت laptop last month. Purchase, like buy. أيضا choose, شو معناتها؟ select. Choose معناتها select. To choose, for example, في الامتحان هيكون choose the best answer, select the best answer, هاي معناتها. Search, search معناتها يبحث. To look for, I am looking for a new apartment, I am looking for a new car, she looked for a new car, he looks for a new cars always, new cars always. Gourmet, شو يعني gourmet؟ gourmet اللي هو specialist in food, المختص في الطعام, الشيف نسميه gourmet. Alone, alone معناها separated from others, nobody with you, alone معناها حزين وحيد. For example, I hate to be separated from others, I hate to be alone, I hate not to be with nobody. Okay, categories. Categories means classifications. How many categories in this class? We have three categories. What are they? Grammar, vocabulary, and reading. So how many categories? We have three categories. Okay. And the last one is easy. Easy is the opposite of difficult. عكس, opposite معناها عكس. هي عكس difficult, صعب. Okay, let us move on now. We have here a kind of exercise. I want you to pay your attention now to these exercises and try to memorize, to know the meaning of these, of these words without looking back to the slide. Where is the car? It is in the library, garage, bag, kitchen. وين احنا بنضع السيارة؟ في الجراج. Number two. If you didn't find the book, you can look for it in the other room. Look for it. شو معناتها؟ To buy, to search, to read, to eat. Which one? To search. معناتها to search. أيضا في عندنا جملة ثالثة. English language is فراغ. It is not difficult. Opposite of difficult. شو معنى شو عكس difficult? Easy. لأن boring معناته ممل. Beautiful معناته جميل وعكسها ugly. And safe عكسها هي معناها آمن وعكسها unsafe. Okay. عكس safe. Unsafe. وعكس boring. Excited وعكس beautiful. Ugly وعكس easy. The opposite of easy is difficult. Okay, so please memorize all of these vocabularies and try to use them in sentences. Okay, the word classifications means A, entertainments, B, eatables, C, categories, D, customers. So classifications. ما معنى classifications? It means categories. Categories معناتها تقسيم, أقسام, أصناف. Okay. حكينا customers هي المستهلكين أو الزبائن. Eatables الأشياء الممكن قابلة للأكل. Entertainments الأشياء الممتعة. To have fun. So categories means classifications. The word gourmet means policeman, food specialist, mechanic, or who works at hospital. Means food specialist, chief نسمي. So this is gourmet, food specialist. How about separated from others? Separated from others. What does it mean? Nobody with you. What does it mean? It means alone. Alone. Happy. معناتها سعيد. حزين معناتها عفوا. حزين اللي هي عكس happy. Alone or sad. حزين. هنا معناها وحيد. أكثر يعني حزين ووحيد متبادلة. sick means مريض. عكس مريض healthy. healthy. busy معناته مشغول. عكس مشغول free. so again memorize all of them. استخدمهم. أنا بكرر الجملة ذاتها للتأكيد. Okay, to emphasize the importance of memorizing all the vocabulary. So please memorize them, احفظوهم, and try to use them like this in sentences. Okay? Okay, this is our last section for today, which is reading. We're having two sections in reading section. The first one is word and pronoun reference. And the second one is going to be about the scanning and skimming. Let us start first reading the passage. Ahmed and his sister are from Riyadh. Ahmed and his sister are from Riyadh. They study English at university. بدرسوا الإنجليزية في الجامعة. She is older than him. هي أكبر منه. لكن he speaks English better than her. يتحدث الإنجليزية أفضل منها. They always go there by bus. It is a very suitable place for practicing English. They always speak English with each other to improve their language. So we have here a list of pronouns, and I want you to guess how these pronouns or to what these pronouns refer. So they are referring to something. Okay, so here we have she refers to. Here is she. في كان عنصر أنثوي في هذه الجملة؟ Yes. اللي هي his sister. His sister, she refers to his sister. أولا sister هي مفردة ومؤنث وشي تأتي مع المفرد والمؤنث. تأتي مع المفرد اللي هو الواحد شخص واحد لكنه مؤنث يعني ليس ذكر. هذا معنى المؤنث. Okay. Him refers to. Him refers to أحمد. أحمد ذكر ومفرد. ذكر ومفرد. لاحظوا she is a subject pronoun وهم خلينا نذكركم فيها هي object pronoun. شو معنى subject pronoun؟ subject pronouns يعني يأتي قبل الفعل. الفعل هو is. بينما object pronoun اللي هي him جاءت بعد الفعل. لاحظوا هذا الفعل وهنا him. they refers to. they للجمع. تيجي للجمع سواء كان ذكر أو أنثى. أوكي ذكر أو أنثى. فthey تأتي مع أحمد and هذا معناها and هيك. هذه الإشارة معناها and his sister. There refers to their. لاحظت الديمونستراتيف pronouns اللي هي ضمائر المكان اللي كانت تدل على الإشارة. There بتدل على مكان على إشارة واللي هو university. He refers to. مرة ثانية he refers to. مثل هم هي ذكر لكنه مفرد واللي هو أحمد. it refers to شيء غير عاقل. it is a very suitable place for practicing English. مكان ملائم لممارسة اللغة الإنجليزية. ف it refers to university. اللي هو المكان. كيف عرفت انه it ترجع للuniversity؟ لانه هي المكان الوحيد في هذا السياق. There refers to their, هي their language. So they always speak English with each other to improve their language. Improve معناها يطور أو يحسن من لغتهم. They refers to Ahmed and his sister. Okay, so this is what we have for word and pronoun reference. Every reading sections we'll be having just an exercise like this one. Okay, the final slide is going to be about scanning and skimming. وإحنا أخذنا في المحاضرات الفاتحة الأولى والثانية والثالثة عن مسألة scanning and skimming. اللي هي skimming حكينا, you move your eyes quickly through the passage to have an overview about the main topic and the main point, the main points of the passage. فأنت بتستخدم skimming, تقرأ القراءة سريعة خلال القطعة لتعرف الجو العام أو الفكرة العامة عن شو بتحكي أو شو فكرة المؤلف. بينما scanning is you're moving your eyes to find specific details, specific information. أنت بتستخدمها لتجد معلومة محددة. بينما scanning تقرأ بشكل عام, ما بتعرف أنت what you are looking for. بينما scanning you know what you are looking for, تعرف أنت لأي معلومة بتبحث عنها. Okay, let's start here. Where are Ahmed and his sister from? They are from, you go back to the sentence, they are from Riyadh. So Ahmed and his sister are from Riyadh. لاحظوا, I skim, I move my eyes quickly through the lines. I read the first line and then I found the answer. Who is better in English? You go back. She's older than him. He speaks English better than her. So, who speaks better in English, better than the other? Ahmed. Ahmed speaks English better than his sister, although his sister is older than him. How do they go to university? You go back. They always, okay, they always go there by bus. حكينا there, بترجع لكلمة university. There, بترجع لكلمة university. ف they go there by bus. They go to university by bus. إذن, how do they go to university? On foot, in a taxi, by plane or by bus? It's by bus. Okay, so in this class we have covered four main ideas. We have started with how the difference between do, does, did, and done, and doing. أنتم مطالبين في أنكم تعرفوا القواعد, the rules, مثل ما علمتكم هون, وتعملوا التمارين. أيضا we have covered prepositions of time. أخذنا حروف الجر المتعلقة في المكان اللي هن at, in, on. وأيضا مطالبين أنكم تعملوا exercises, التمارين. وأيضا دخلنا في موضوع اللي هو vocabulary previewing. أعطيتكم a list of words or vocabulary. You need to memorize them and you need to know how to use them. وفي النهاية أخذنا reading section, أخذنا فيها مهارتين, مهارة word and pronoun reference with scanning and skimming. أرجو that you have I'm mixing between Arabic and English, just to understand. So hopefully you have enjoyed my class, and hopefully I will see you next time. Thank you so much. I will see you next time. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.